everybody, this is Praxis, and we're back on site again today. My dad is here working with me. Josh was here earlier. Josh spent all the time that he was here taking these balusters and getting them all nice and smooth and sanded. These are reused pieces of wood that my dad had kicking around. That's why they got some old holes in there. They had some Sharpie on them. The Sharpie was able to sand off. We weren't sure about that, how deeply the Sharpie would have stained down into the wood, but the Sharpie sanded off just fine. They need a little bit more cleaning up, and I think if we stained them, they would, you know, it would look even better, but so far, they're really nice, really smooth, and that's all done. This is, obviously, the bottom of the lower set of stairs, and the reason I wanted to shoot here today, in addition to the fact that it just looks really awesome, my dad's been putting this together, little skirts on the sides, so, you know, dirt doesn't fall off the edges and everything, he put together these posts. The reason I wanted to shoot here, in addition to all of that, is specifically because this is not where this post was originally supposed to be. In fact, this staircase is not where the staircase was originally supposed to be. If you recall from a while ago, because of the fact that making the stairs that much higher down here would have made them illegal according to code, I needed to add an extra step in the run. So that took the run of stairs and it pushed it this way an extra 10 inches because each stair is 10 inches. Obviously compressed the amount of space we have here. And the original plan was that the posts would be right at the bottom of the bottom step. In having the steps be kicked out another 10 inches, when we put it up, it just looked really cramped. If you can imagine a post being right here, it was a really tight area. It was going to be okay by the code, but it was cramped, it was awkward, and if this is the way that you get everything up into the upper levels of the house, washing machine, bed frames, mattresses, bureaus, everything that's going to go upstairs has to go through here. Why turn this into a horrible, irritating bottleneck? So, despite the fact that my dad the other day put this post in and he did a great job of it, it was, you know, true plum, beautiful and everything, we both were thinking, actually, we both emailed each other. He went to email me and saw it. I had already emailed him asking, how much of a pain in the butt would it be to move that post? And we were both thinking the same thing. It bothered us that it just took this nice open space, it's easy to navigate, and it made it awkward. So the reason I wanted to talk about that is it's always important to reevaluate your plans and reevaluate how things are going. Step back and don't be afraid to maybe take a little bit of time and change things because, you know, if you're building a homestead that you might live in for the rest of your life, you don't want something like that's always irritating you that you think, you know, if only I'd spent an extra, how long did it take you to move the post?
A couple hours.
You know, you don't want something irritating you because you wanted to save a couple of hours 10 years ago. So I think it's great that it was no skin off my teeth. it was no effort on my part. But I think it's great that it got moved and it'll just make it a lot, more functional going forward. Incidentally, this isn't solid. This is hollow on the inside. We're going to be putting the light switches for going up and down all these stairs inside the posts. You go and you flip them right in here. And it is going to be a five-way or a six-way, right?
Yeah.
We'll see. A five-way means that you've got four light switches and one light, or one set of lights. A six-way means you get five light switches and one set of lights. The reason we're talking about having so many of them is it'd be neat if you turn the lights on here, go all the way up, and then turn them off if your destination is all the way up. Instead of having to turn them on here, off of the top, at the next run, off of the next one. I think it would make it a lot simpler just having switch on where you start, switch off where you finish. That's it. Thanks for watching.